Alright, I just finished recording a video of this Panasonic VHS-C camcorder. We're going to do a video of the other camcorder I have as well. Which is this. This is a 1995 Sony Handycam. What model is it? Let's see. Sony Handycam CCD FX730VE. This is a Video 8 camcorder from the mid-1990s, of course. It's got that black look to it, not being racist, but it's got that black look to it, like most 1990s stuff. I do not have the battery for this camcorder, but thankfully I do have the power cord, the power adapter for it, so I'd be able to power it on for you guys. I just have to plug it into the power strip underneath my desk. Anyway, I'm not going to be able to do a test video on this because this tape in this the tape on this camcorder is completely full of footage that I do have to digitalize and stuff like that. So I don't want to mess up the tape. But I tried putting a Hi8 tape into this and it just rejected it as soon as I tried to put it in. Because Video8 and Hi8 tapes share the same case, they're just different type of tape, but they can fit in each other, but they won't work. Because I can put this Video8 tape in my Hi8 camcorder as well, in my Samsung Hi8 camcorder, and it goes in, but it won't play. But if I put the Hi8 tape in this camcorder, I can put it in, but it will eject straight away on its own. But let's go around this camcorder. I want mine on. There you go. This thing is a monster compared to the camera I'm recording with, which is also a Handycam. This is my camera I'm recording with is a Handycam, Sony Handycam DCR SX65. Most of my regular viewers would know, but if you just stumbled upon this video on YouTube, then yeah. Anyway, just by searching. Anyway, so as you can see, the lens. This thing has an automatic lens cap, which is awesome. So I can just flip the power switch and, of course, there's no battery in it, but still, it opens a lens cap, so it's pretty good. It's better than the other one that was on the Samsung. I mean, on the Panasonic. My Samsung has another type of glass. This camera I'm using now to record this also has an automatic lens cap, which is awesome. Yeah, 12 times optical zoom, 12x optical zoom, which is wow, it's just not that good at all, really, compared to today's standards, because the camera I'm using now is a 2011 Sony Handycam, and that's got 70 times optical zoom. And I don't think this has digital zoom at all, so that's good, because digital zoom is a waste of time. It's just pointless. I really should have kept my light on. There we are. So we have power, we flip it up, we press the green button, flip it up to get power, flip it in the middle to go off, and flip down the button to play. The fader button, it's like you've had a fade effect. Here is the screen, which I didn't even know in the 1990s that they had glossy screens. But that, indeed folks, is a glossy screen. I loathe glossy screens. My desktop computer has a glossy screen. That's my screensaver. My laptop doesn't, though. I'm lucky my laptop doesn't have a glossy screen. My new laptop does, but I am buying it. My new laptop I'm getting the Asus machine has, but I'm getting a screen protector for it. So I'm just trying to adjust my camera here. Alright, there we are. It's coming off my little mini tripod. Sorry about this. If you can't already tell, I do not prepare for my videos. Okay. There we go. Nice and happy. Anyway, but as you can see, it's a glossy screen, which is a fingerprint magnet, a dust magnet, and a glare magnet too. So it drives me insane. But I really don't see the point in having a glossy screen. But at least it's got a screen. At least this camera actually has a screen in. Because it is a 1990s camcorder, and my 2002 Samsung Hi8 does not have a screen. So yeah, But we do have a viewfinder, which I think is kind of pointless. It's a black and white viewfinder as well, so if you have the screen, I really don't see the point of the viewfinder. I mean, seriously. But, you know, this was in the 1990s. On the screen, we do have the eject button to open it. It's not a magnetic latch, like today's ones. And the brightness control, which you don't see a brightness wheel these days. You don't see them anymore. Just lift your viewfinder up here, because it's getting in the way. We open the screen, and we have some controls in here. We have a speaker, the menu button, some more controls, the execute button, like to select your menu options, I think. Yeah, there you're up and down arrows to select your items. Got display counter reset, so if you're in a playback and you want to reset the counter for where the tape is at, then you can. And different buttons, volume wheel. So you got more buttons here. Program backlight composition, which is actually pretty good for 1995. The battery eject, which I do not have a battery in this thing. That's where the battery goes. And but the power adapter I have for it, if I just unwrap the cord here, what that is, it actually goes into the camcorder. There actually is no power jack. What you do is, the battery charger, actually, what it is, it actually goes into the battery slot on the camera, and you can plug your battery into the charger here, but you can also plug this into your camcorder, so you can power up your camcorder while the battery is charging. I wish, there you go. So I can power up the camcorder now, but as you can see, it goes into the back there, and you can, yeah, and you press the eject button and slide it out. So I'm not gonna have that in right now, so I'll just chuck it on the floor like a retard. Sorry about that. We have the Sony lanyard thing. The lock, which this thing I find really annoying, you switch it up to actually use the camera mode and you switch it down to lock it. So you can eject the tape and stuff. I forget how it works, but and you have the record button here as well. So, like, basically nearly all cameras have the record button right at your thumb. You have a hand strap. There's something under here. Let me just. That's where the little lithium battery goes to hold the date and time, which I'm surprised that's the original battery and still holding the date and time correctly. That's amazing, and this thing hasn't been used like in ages. It only started getting used again when I got it like a couple of weeks ago. Now we have your connection video and audio out. I think it's out. I haven't actually powered this thing on. Oh, I haven't even connected it to TV. We have some more connectors there. That's where the tape goes. You flip this little switch here, and this little door comes out, which I actually don't like. Let me just put the viewfinder back down there. I actually turn the light off here. It's anyway, slide it open like that, and you can eject the tape. The tape goes inside there. Like, where you eject it is, you slide that. You press this blue eject button, then this tape thing comes out, and then pull the tape out, put a new one in, and yeah, and Bob's your uncle. The top here we have the zoom slider and your playback controls. And we also have another port here. I think it's I think it's an external mic port. I'm not really sure. And so let me just plug the power adapter in. I'm too lazy to edit this video. Well, actually, I do edit my videos, but don't really feel like putting another clip. So let me just plug it in. Still have to remove my external hard drive's power cord for a second, and plug this into the. Just lift the viewfinder up a bit so I can do it. A viewfinder does get in the way; it's really quite pointless. Anyway, as you can see, well, you might be able to see, there's a green light on the battery charger here. Let me just open up the screen. Now this screen doesn't actually flip around like most camcorder screens. Like you that's the only way you can flip it, like that, or like that, and you can't turn it around either. So it only goes like that, and like that, or closed, if you don't want to use it. We're going to use it though, of course, because I want to look through a viewfinder. And turn it on, and we're going to turn this lock switch. And it's going to try and eject the tape at me. Whoa, we're getting something. I'm going to just turn the brightness. Actually, maybe not for the camera, but... Alright, something's gone wrong. And, it's yelling at me for something. Alright, try and eject the tape here. See, the tape mechanism just comes out like this. And pull your tape out. It's just a Video8 tape. And, alright, don't start yelling at me. And, you know, there you go, there is your camcorder. This screen is actually bigger than the one on the Panasonic I showed you in another video. If you haven't seen it, go to my channel, it's there. But, let me adjust this camera. As you can very well tell, I do not organize for my videos. Wait a second, I'm actually going to move up away from my computer there, because it's kind of cramped because my keyboard is in the way. There you go, this is a better view now. Let me just, adjust my camera there, and this thing is huge. That is what she said. But, in zoom in to the Intel Celery and Windows XP stickers on my computer over there, my media machine. Yes, I call a Celeron Celery because it's a pile of junk. The Celerons are just nothing but utter crap. As you can see, we have, just move that stupid viewfinder out of the way. If I go into the menu, which I don't actually think I've ever gone into. Can I even go into it, or is this stupid button not going to work? No, it's going to be a piece of celery. Okay. Alright, so let's just go into the, I'm not sure if you can hear it, but I think the viewfinder is actually a CRT screen. You know those old fat CRT monitors? I think the viewfinder is actually one of those because it whines like some CRTs do. So if I listen, I'm not sure if you can. I'm just going to put my camera's microphone up to it. But if I close the screen... you can hear some sort of whining noise, like a very high-pitched whining. And then when I open the screen, the viewfinder turns off. It stops. Anyway. I'm gonna look through the viewfinder here, and you know, it's not that good, but I mean, seriously, who the hell wants to walk through a black and white viewfinder when you have a color screen? Let's go into the playback mode, so we just rewind the tape. Oh, there's a rewind button. There it is. Fast forward, actually. Actually, it's locked, so I gotta unlock it to do that. To use these media controls, you actually gotta unlock it with the lock switch. Fast forward so you can just hear the motor. Just so you can hear it, I'm bringing it up. And there you go. I'm ejecting tape. And that is how the tape comes out. If I didn't show you before, and then there's your tape, you just put it in. close that, then lock it, which will actually make it come out. Ah, shut up, stupid thing. Nah, it's still gonna scream at me. I just showed it off, piece of junk. It's a bit complicated to use, and yeah, but it is a vintage camcorder, if you will. So let me just update that on the tripod. A crappy tripod is that too. It's one of those stupid little desk ones, like one of those. One of the stupid Joby ones. Like, they're crap, I hate them. I don't hate it, but you know. Stupid thing that goes on. There we are. Okay. So, but that is a video of this Sony Handycam. Forget the model number, seriously, I do. CCD-FX730VE. Camcorder, Video8 camcorder from the 1990s, from the mid-1990s, I think 1995, because there's footage on this tape from 1996 and 1995, so I think that's when it's from, but it certainly looks like it's from that era as well, so yeah. Hope you enjoyed this video, and thank you for watching, and have a nice day, if you so desire to.